All right, it looks like we got a pretty steady number in here now, so we'll get started with the presentation. I'd like to welcome everyone, and I hope you're all doing well. I'd also like to thank you for taking the time out of your day to join this webinar. Our focus today will be on dams, dikes, levees, and spillways. I'm your host, Corey Schneider, Business Development Manager with Presto Geosystems. I have a master's in environmental science and have been working at Presto for 14 years, specializing in technical and site support. We are located in Wisconsin and manufacture erosion control, stormwater management, and porous pavement products that are used all over the US and the world. I have everyone muted for the presentation, so if you have questions, please type them into the question window and I will answer them at the conclusion of the presentation. Today, we'll learn how the GEOWEB system can protect against erosion from water flow in a variety of project conditions, how GEOCells can accommodate typical construction issues and design challenges, and how GEOWEB can reduce vertical pressure on subgrades to allow for a reduced cross-section in load support applications. First, a little background on Presto. We worked with the Army Corps of Engineers to develop GEOCell technology in the late 1970s and have been innovating ever since. Our products have been used in over 200 countries and in every state in the United States. We do pride ourselves in going beyond simply providing a product. We have a lot of design and construction resources available on our website, which is prestogeo.com. We do have a team of experienced engineers on staff that can assist you with project evaluations. We'll talk about those a little more in depth later, but we do have forms on our website that you can give us some project specific information, and our engineers will run some calculations and give you recommended cross sections, anchorage patterns, and infill. We also do provide contractor support. That can happen either through Presto or we do sell through a local distribution network. So many times our local distributor would be on site to assist the contractor in not only installing the products correctly, but also as efficiently as possible. We operate in three general product areas: soil stabilization using our GEOWEB GEOCells, which can be used for load support, slope and channel protection, and constructing green retaining walls. We've got porous pavements, both vegetated and aggregate solutions, and we also have lightweight reusable construction mats. Today, we're going to focus on GEOWEB, with the main focus being on slope and hydraulic performance, but we'll also cover load support applications briefly. We'll start out with some general information about our GEOWEB GEOCells. As I mentioned, Presto worked with the Army Corps of Engineers to develop GEOCell technology. Many different materials were tested, including aluminum, cardboard, and wax paper. But in the end, high-density polyethylene, or HDPE, was the chosen material due to its lightweight, flexible nature and the fact that it is inert to nearly all chemicals and climate conditions. So basically, we just extrude sheets of HDPE, cut them to the proper cell depth, and ultrasonically weld them together. So the GEOWEB system consists of two main attributes. The first is the cell size. The cells come in three different diameters, small, medium, and large, which we refer to as our 20V, 30V, and 40V, and heights of 3, 4, 6, 8, and 12 inches. Cell aperture and height are selected following an evaluation of project-specific needs and site conditions. The ultrasonically welded seam, where all of the connecting points are, is very important to the function of a GEOCell. The stronger the seam strength, the better the performance of the GEOCell. A strong seam allows for heavier infill material, steeper and taller slopes, and better lifetime performance. GEOWEB is produced using high quality virgin, high density polyethylene resin for consistently strong welds at cell junctions, while also maintaining semi-rigid ductile properties within the cell walls. High stress crack resistance and overall toughness and long-term durability in the environment. Our geocells do not use fillers or exotic polymer alloy blends, which can ultimately reduce weld strength and environmental stress crack resistance, and that are offered in some competing products in the name of increasing cell wall stiffness. To avoid weld failures and the damaging effects of differential settlement, uniformity in performance across all elements of a geocell system is much more important than stiffness alone. To facilitate installation, we offer 5 different section lengths. The table on the right is a very general representation for summary purposes only, showing which cell size and cell depth is generally recommended for each different application. We do recommend that you use our evaluation service, which again is free of charge, so that we can select the most cost-effective cell wall or cell size and cell depth combination that will lead to a successful project. A typical GEOWEB panel comes tri-folded and palletized. Each section has a nominal width of 8.5 feet with lengths up to 58 feet. Panels are flexible, opening like an accordion, so they can follow the natural contours of the worksite without being confined to a rigid set of dimensions. They can also easily be field cut to accommodate any dimensions that you require. Here you see some of our standard performance and material specifications. As you can see, there's a lot of information packed into our standard spec sheet. We don't have time to go through everything line by line, and I'm sure you wouldn't want to do that anyway, but I at least wanted to provide you with a sense of what a typical geocell product spec sheet should look like. You'll note that it contains a lot of detail on key material properties, including weld strength and ESCR, which is environmental stress crack resistance, which I mentioned earlier. And just a general note when reviewing product spec sheets for geocells, and any geosynthetic product for that matter, you will want to pay close attention to any disclaimer language a product provider tries to sneak into the fine print, usually at the bottom of the page. Recently, we've noticed a concerning trend where low-end product providers present performance data that appears to equal industry accepted standards on the surface, but then they add disclaimer language in the fine print at the bottom of the page stating that their specifications are subject to change without notice, or the information shown is for general purposes and not intended for design. So this is just a heads up to watch out for this type of trap, especially if you get hit with a request from a contractor on one of your projects to evaluate a substitute product. Our spec sheet contains no disclaimers and we stand behind our numbers, so you can deliver certainty in the solution as you build with materials you can trust. The system components are all the supporting pieces that make GEOWEB the most complete geocell system and also ensure relatively uniform performance of the interconnected system, thereby protecting against the damaging effects of non-uniform deformation and differential settlement in response to applied loads. Presto's GEOWEB is equipped with numerous design and construction components that increase strength and speed of installation. Starting on the upper right-hand corner here, we've got our ATRA key, which we use to connect sections together, both side to side and end to end. And then our ATRA tendon clip with the tendon system, and I'll show a little bit more on those in the next couple of slides. We also do have a variety of different anchors available. We've got a cap, which is called our ATRA stake clip, which is used with a standard number 4 or 1/2 inch diameter rebar. So the cap just fits right over the top of the rebar, and one of these arms gets hooked over the top of a cell wall. So we have good solid connection between the anchor and the GEOWEB material. If you are concerned about corrosion of those rebar long-term, if you're maybe in saltwater applications or highly acidic soils, we can provide either a fiberglass rod or a plastic rod, which is very handy for load support applications as you don't have to worry about tire puncture. So either one of those work the same way as the atrostate clip and rebar, where one of these arms goes over the top of the cell wall and you get that good solid connection between your anchor and the GEOWEB material. And with any of our anchoring systems, we do have a GAD that works with a pneumatic driver, and that is going to fit right over the top of the anchor head to facilitate very easy installation. So as I mentioned, I'll focus a little bit more on two of the accessories. First, the ATRA key. And the ATRA key is going to provide three times the connection strength and about twice as fast installation time when compared to the traditional method of stapling. They also are polymer, so they won't rust, which can prevent future failures and do not require any tools to install. So here's a quick little video of the ATRA key in use. And you can see you simply slide it through the slot and turn it 90 degrees. Very quick and easy way to connect those sections together, both side to side and end to end. Then we typically use tendon anchorage on long steep slopes or for installations over a geomembrane, which are often, if not always, part of an earthen dam solution. Our ATRA tendon clips are very advantageous when anchoring with tendons. The tendons are securely fastened to the tendon clip, and the tendon clip is securely attached to the GEOWEB, so there's no chance for slipping. This also allows for top of slope pre-assembly, limiting the amount of work that has to actually take place on the slope for a faster, safer assembly. So we'll take a quick look at how that would work. Basically, we have charts that tell you the spacing that you'll need between ATRA tendon clips on the tendon, so you can assemble that all on the top of the slope. And as we can see here, just drag it down. Everything will be connected and properly placed so that there really is no work to be done on the slope itself at all, except for connecting the sections side to side as you progress with the installation. So now we'll look at some application specific uses of the GEOWEB system, starting with the armoring of dams, dikes, and levees. A typical earthen dam or dike application might look something like is shown here. On the wet side, we'd have GEOWEB armoring, generally with an aggregate or concrete infill, with the infill type mostly dependent on wave action as well as drawdown rates. The cells could then be expanded over the top of the dike and down the dry side. This would provide a stable driving surface at the crest, so we'd infill with aggregate. Then on the dry side, we could transition to a topsoil vegetation solution. This will allow for natural aesthetics while still providing erosion protection should the dam overtop. So I mentioned that GEOWEB could be used to stabilize the crest of a dam or levee to create a drivable surface, which would be a load support application. So we'll go a little more in depth on that application first. The three-dimensional GEOWEB system works this way for load support applications. When a vertical load is applied, the active earth pressure in the loaded cell pushes back against the passive earth pressure in the adjacent cell to form a stable system. Each cell helps support the ones around it. The GEOWEB cell walls also transfer hoop stress, which is important in keeping the system intact and creates a mattress effect. the strength of the seams around each cell, the material properties of the individual strips, and the connection method between panels are all important factors in determining how the geocell system can improve load-bearing capacity. Strong seams, semi-ductile resin properties, and integrated connections are critical to a well-performing system. The GEOWEB system and accessories are specifically designed to work together to be an effective solution for porous pavements, specifically in soft soil locations. Here you can see the stresses on the subgrade with the unsupported subgrade on the left and GEOWEB reinforcement on the right. Notice how there is a complete elimination of the highest stresses at the surface when using GEOWEB reinforcement. The stresses are reduced and distributed over a wider area, which we call the mattress effect. This mattress effect reduces stresses reaching the subgrade and leads to a significant decrease in deflection and rutting. In the top schematic here, we have unconfined aggregate that moves down and out, leading to a lot of maintenance. We're also not utilizing the full strength of the aggregate as it's able to move around. By adding GEOWEB to the section, we greatly reduce maintenance through confinement because there's nowhere for that infill to go. And it also gives added strength to the infill by adding apparent cohesion, allowing us to reduce section depth. Now we'll take a look at a couple of lab tests to give you an idea of exactly how the use of GEOWEB can benefit your load support application. We started out here with 1 meter of supersaturated peat, and over the peat, the GEOWEB section was placed and infilled with gravel. Settlement plates were placed throughout the GEOWEB section prior to its placement. A load beam was placed over the GEOWEB section and loaded to failure. This was then compared to an unreinforced aggregate section. So this test showed that bases reinforced with GEOWEB provide a significant improvement over unreinforced soils. For a loading of 1,000 pounds per foot, a 4-inch rut depth occurred in the GEOWEB section, whereas the unreinforced soil had about a 20-inch rut depth. So that was our static load test. We also had a dynamic load test performed. So here the pavement load testing compared the performance of GEOWEB reinforced and unreinforced aggregate. Each section was loaded until it experienced 0.6 inch of deformation. For the non-GEOWEB section, this took about 25,000 load cycles. And by adding GEOWEB to the section, the number of load cycles went up to 400,000, an increase of about 16 times the number of load cycles. You can imagine how this would improve the life cycle cost of any pavement. So generally speaking, a few of the benefits of using GEOWEB in unpaved roads include a reduction of the aggregate cross-section of 70% or more. The GEOWEB will also control lateral and vertical infill movement, which prevents shearing, and it creates a stiff base with a high flexural strength. So, as we're talking about dams here, we'll now go on to discuss the slope protection system. And using GEOWEB is going to allow for steeper stabilized slopes that are resistant to erosion, and they're going to be much more effective than two-dimensional systems such as turf reinforcement mats and erosion control blankets. We can do one-to-one slopes and even steeper, but keep in mind that this is just a surficial protection layer here. So to use this GEOWEB in this manner, you do need a globally stable slope. GEOWEB is an economical alternative to large riprap and reinforced concrete for dam faces and spillways, and can even allow for vegetated faces that otherwise would not be possible due to the hydraulic forces at play. If rock is used, GEOWEB allows you to greatly reduce the rock size, and with concrete, we can cut the required concrete depth in half when compared to reinforced concrete solutions. So here's what a typical cross-section of a slope protection would look like, showing some of the anchoring options, including stakes, which we see here, and that tendon system. So the tendon is typically going to be tied off to either a dead man pipe or an earth anchor at the crest, depending on how much room you have up there. And then you can see the tendon clips spaced periodically down the slope. So the structural benefits of using GEOWEB on slopes is that it will encapsulate infill and protect it against movement caused by runoff and sloughing of saturated soil. And it will also limit undermining by confining that upper layer of fill. We can support a variety of different infills, as I mentioned, topsoil and vegetation, aggregate, as well as concrete. And the way GEOWEB works is that the cellular network creates check dams that protect the upper soil or aggregate layer from hydrological erosive forces, such as dam overtopping, that can impact unconfined material. With the GEOWEB and vegetation option, topsoil is confined in the cells, and then typically the cells would be covered with a turf reinforcement mat, and this system can withstand very high velocities and shear stresses and can replace large riprap or concrete in many cases. The system was tested at the Colorado State University Hydraulics Lab using 6-inch GEOWEB filled with topsoil, covered with a mid-grade turf reinforcement mat, and fully vegetated. And it achieved some pretty amazing results. It withstood 29 feet per second and 16 pounds of shear without failure, which is more than twice the hydraulic resistance of 12-inch riprap, and about double the performance of a high-performance turf reinforcement mat alone. So this system works because the turf reinforcement mat provides cover for the GEOWEB, so there is no scouring out of the cells, and the GEOWEB will confine the soil below the turf reinforcement mat so that it doesn't wash downstream when saturated, which is how TRMs alone fail. It was also tested in an unvegetated condition, and we found that GEOWEB improves the hydraulic performance of the TRM alone by about 30%. So you get significant first day performance improvement, and it really gets to its full strength when that vegetation is fully established. We also tested aggregate infill at Colorado State with the high number of data points. Having tested three different cell sizes and two different rock sizes, Colorado State was able to create a regression equation for us. And with this equation, it will allow us to perform analysis. So given a bed slope and a unit discharge of a particular channel or dam face, we can manipulate the rock size and cell size until we get to a point where your rock loss L is zero. When compared to traditional riprap sizing tools like those of Abson Johnson and the Army Corps of Engineers, we find that through confinement, we're able to reduce your rock size anywhere from 2 to 10 times, which can lead to significant savings in rock cost as well as transportation and installation. So the large variance in the rock reduction is due to bed slope. We can reduce the rock size more on flatter bed slopes and lesser in steeper areas. The final infill we'll take a look at is concrete. It can be poured in place with no additional forms or reinforcement, as the GEOWEB cell walls act as both. Confinement also allows for the use of easier to place, higher slump concrete and assures uniform concrete depth throughout the slope. Generally, a 3,000 to 1,000 PSI concrete is used for the infill. And 3-inch concrete filled GEOWEB can replace 5 to 6 inch depth of reinforced concrete. Once anchored, the GEOWEB allows the concrete to be pumped or poured right into the cells, like we can see in these photos here. And then you simply screed and finish right to the top of the cells. We definitely do not want to overfill the GEOWEB in these applications, because any concrete that is over the top of the cell walls is going to not be reinforced or confined, so it will definitely spall off over time. Notice the flexibility of the system, which is displayed in the photo on the right. So basically all those cell walls act as joints. So we're going to provide for controlled minimal cracking and create a flexible system. Again, we had very impressive results for the concrete filled version of the system with our 3-inch cell depth withstanding 36 feet per second and 21 pounds of shear. And that did not even fail the system, but rather maxed out the flume. And I believe we were the only product that's been tested out at Colorado State that was able to max out the outdoor flume without failure. We'll now go over a few case studies, the first being Mud Lake Dam in Gardnerville, Nevada. This was a 100-year-old earthen dam that no longer met safety standards and needed to be rehabilitated. A cost-effective alternative to traditional reinforced concrete was needed, so the selected solution involved a 16-ounce non-woven geotextile, a 45-mil polypropylene geomembrane, and then another 16-ounce non-woven geotextile. Over the top of that went the 3-inch concrete-filled GEOWEB anchored with tendons and a dead man pipe to avoid puncturing the liner. In the pictures, we see the geomembrane being placed over the geotextile. The geomembrane, of course, provides an impermeable waterproof barrier that prevents saturation of the earthen structure. Tendons and load transfer clips were placed within the GEOWEB sections in assembly areas off slope. This minimized the amount of time the contractor had to spend on the slope, increasing speed and safety. With a 3-inch GEOWEB layer as a form, concrete is expediently placed over the entire 2-to-1 or 26.5 degree dam face. Concrete was poured into the cells near the crest and pumped into the cells in the areas further from the crest. The GEOWEB alternative cost about $10 a square foot installed and offered cost savings of around $600,000 over the 90,000 square foot project. Savings of roughly $6.67, or 40% per square foot when compared to traditional reinforced concrete. Moving on to a vegetated solution on the dry side of a dam. Lake Hefner Dam in Oklahoma experienced erosion damage along the bank and under the road on the dry side of the dam over a number of years from overtopping and sheet flow from the roadway. Excessive rains and high winds contributed to the overtopping issues that caused erosion on the opposite side of the roadway. The lake side of the dam is protected from erosion by placement of new riprap, and the GEOWEB slope protection system is installed on the opposite embankment to prevent future soil erosion and sloughing. The system was placed on the 2-to-1 roadway embankment and anchored with Atra stakes. And here we see the final results, a fully vegetated GEOWEB slope protection system. Here we've got the Hickory Mound impoundment in Florida. So in this application, the concrete filled GEOWEB covered both the side slopes and the crest of the dam, providing a smooth drivable surface at the crest. Spillways are also fairly common applications, and we'll just look at a couple examples of those. 4-inch concrete filled GEOWEB was utilized at this medical complex in Tallahassee, Florida. Approximately 460 square yards was used for the flume and another 230 square yards for the spillway apron. The spillway empties into a holding pond that is designed to capture runoff for the 82-acre development. Here we have one more example of a hard armored GEOWEB spillway, this one at a country club in Pennsylvania. So I mentioned earlier that no forms were needed when using concrete filled GEOWEB, and that is true, but notice here that they put a form board at the edges of the GEOWEB installation. This allowed them to create a nice straight line at the edge rather than having that jagged look of the cell fins. Again, the benefits of using concrete filled GEOWEB for applications like this is that you can reduce the concrete depth, you don't need additional forms or reinforcement, and its flexible nature will handle some differential settlement. All in all, it's a much more economical solution than reinforced concrete. So today we looked at some innovative solutions for dams, dikes, and levees. But before we get to the questions, I want to remind you that we provide a complete solution, and part of that is our technical assistance. The engineering team here at Presto Geosystems works closely with engineers, offering that free project evaluation service for any road, embankment, or erosion control project. The form is on our website, prestogeo.com, and you simply fill it out with as much information as you have, including being able to attach documents such as geotechnical reports. And then our engineering team would receive that here in Wisconsin. And within 3 business days, but usually faster, we would provide you a complete design evaluation, including infill recommendations, anchorage requirements, and backing calculations. We will work with you to get you the best design for your project. We also have a SpecMaker tool available on our website. SpecMaker allows you to create full project-specific CSI specs as a Word document in just minutes. We will typically provide one with your evaluation, or you can go to our website and create one yourself. We deliver quality and over 40 years of expertise, guaranteeing each shipment meets or exceeds our specifications, so you can deliver certainty and build with materials you can trust. We have no disclaimers or concerning fine print. Hopefully we covered all the learning objectives to your satisfaction. If you would like to discuss anything in more detail, you can contact me directly. We're now making it faster and easier for you to obtain your PDH certificates. With our new webinar dashboard, you can easily view our webinars and download PDH certificates for on-demand and live webinars attended. Your webinar dashboard will keep a record of all on-demand webinars completed, along with PDH credits earned. A link with more information and instructional videos will be emailed to you within the next couple of days. Those of you who are in attendance today will automatically receive a PDH certificate within the next 24 hours. Note that this will come from GoToWebinar and not from Presto, so be on the lookout for it. Depending on your company's cybersecurity setup, you may want to check your spam folder at the end of the week if you haven't received your certificate. So I'd like to thank all of you for attending today. My contact information is here with my cell phone and my email as well, and also the Presto website, which again is prestogeo.com. So if there are any questions that come up later, please feel free to send me an email or give me a call. Now I'll check the question box and take care of anything that came up during the course of the presentation. All right, we will start at the top here. The HDPE material, is it affected by ultraviolet rays? No, we do have carbon black added to that. So we've done accelerated lab testing to show that it doesn't even begin to break down for more than 140 years. So pretty significant UV protection on that. So it won't be a problem. And additionally, I mean, it's generally not really exposed to UV rays because once it's filled, there's no rays getting to it. Another question here, once the GEOWEB system is installed for slope protection, does it require any maintenance? I would say, generally speaking, with the topsoil and vegetation or concrete infill, there should be almost no maintenance required. With an aggregate infill, you may potentially have to periodically take a look at it and, you know, see if any of the aggregate has washed out over time. But even with the aggregate infill, the most maintenance you're going to have is maybe having to top dress it every, you know, it's hard to guess depending on the application, but, you know, maybe every 5 years or something. How does the GEOWEB cost compare to rock riprap and TRM? I mean, that would be more of a local thing because riprap costs are going to vary from location to location. As far as a TRM, it's certainly going to be more expensive than TRMs alone, but it's also much more effective. Is GEOWEB accepted by local agencies and highway departments? Certainly is. In most cases, we are not on like DOT pre-approval lists because there isn't really a category that most DOTs have for that geocells fit into. But we have been used, I would say, if not in all 50 states by the DOT, at least 40 of them. And they're typically, they fall under the special provision. Is a TRM required for a vegetated slope of say 2:1 or is it optional? It really depends on what sort of hydraulic force, hydraulic forces you may be anticipating. We typically are going to cover these vegetated slopes with either a TRM, an erosion control blanket, or at least with hydroseed. But it's really going to depend on the specific application. And we can certainly make recommendations. Is there a price list for GEOWEB? There is not. But the person that asked this, you're free to send me an email and I can get you in touch with the local distributor who can get you some budgetary pricing. So that looks like it's it for the questions. Again, you can see my contact information up here if you want to jot that down if anything comes up in the future, or you can go to our website and find contact information for the entire Presto team. Just want to thank everyone once again for attending and hope to talk with you guys later on. Hope you have a good day. And we'll be signing off now.